Must do something about this hair, viewers. Yeah, I went there about 5 years ago, and it's a good place, but the thing I remember most was the toilets there, because they're very different from things. You notice differences, don't you? Tend to notice differences. And they've got... we've got the big drop mechanism over here, where your doings go down, you know what I mean? And over there, there's a ledge, and your doings go on the ledge.
Oh, right.
Continental shelf.
But you see... The thing is, we're stars, we don't do nasty things like that. We have no need to go to the toilet.
Well, here's a poem anyway. This is called Amsterdam.
Apt.
Cheers. In Amsterdam, I saw a tram.
That kind of encapsulates everything, doesn't it?
Now we go to the real you two, who've made this video exclusively for us on tour in Europe, and it's even better than the real thing. Don't do that, it's disgusting.
To serve the age, one must betray it, or something like that. These are not the pretensions chewed into the naked city.
You two have always had a tense relationship with the British media, who've described them as pompous and arrogant. In return, the band have always been reluctant to give interviews or to play the media game. But things have changed, and the band have given Naked City unprecedented access to their own archives, as well as an exclusive interview. It remains to be seen, however, whether they're finally playing the media game or just playing games.
Let me introduce you to my band.
Where is H? There he is. Don't you think he's an exciting pop star?
We're having a lot of fun, and more fun than we have had probably since the band started.
Larry Mullen Jr. Giving Bruce Springsteen a run for his money, I'd say.
I've never defended you two. I'm not about to start now, especially for some arty-farty TV program.
There's Adam Clayton. There's the cat that got the cream.
As long as I look good, I can keep answering questions.
Look what you've done to me. You've made me very famous. And I thank you.
If you give a pop star a shit pile of dough and he refuses to self-destruct, I think it is a bit wet, and I think it's part of the deal. And if they don't die on a cross at 33, I'd ask for your money back.
Bono was 33 this year, and although certain factions of the British press have long been out to crucify him, you two appear to have achieved a remarkable resurrection, becoming postmodern media darlings.
Never trust the cowboy.
Their first album, Boy, thrust U2 into the public eye, but the naive young band from Dublin weren't yet equipped with the pop paraphernalia to please the image-conscious British media.
English rock and roll is preoccupied with surface in a not uninteresting way. We hadn't yet figured out how to slide, if you know what I mean, down the surface of things.
U2 was kind of growing, and I guess it had an arrogance that any band of teenagers needed to have just to break out of the system. And I think culturally, perhaps the British media didn't understand that energy.
With the Joshua Tree, U2 became the biggest band in the world. In America, where biggest is best, they were welcomed as rock gods. But back home, the reception was different. To be a success was bad enough, but to be proud of it was unforgivable.
Rock and roll is about being big. You know, momentum is one of the players. And, you know, if you want cottage industry, like, take up knitting.
I stand accused of the things I've said.
With the release of the movie Rattle and Hum, U2 were accused of self-indulgence on a grand scale.
I guess we did take ourselves too seriously. But that wasn't our crime. Our crime was being seen to take ourselves too seriously.
In the beginning, the idea of wearing sunglasses in an interview seemed kind of stupid. Now we realize that, in fact, it's not whether you're wearing sunglasses that's important, it's what kind of sunglasses you're wearing.
Never trust a cowboy.
Just when their critics thought that U2 were too rich and too successful to care, the band turned full circle, engaging in a campaign of subversive self-publicity. Suddenly for U2, the media was the message.
I think it's fair to say that you become attracted to the things you're afraid of.
Initially, we thought to ourselves, well, this is either going to be a new beginning or it's going to be a very, very spectacular way of shooting yourself in the head and ending the career of the band. Welcome to Zoo TV.
Zoo TV is a multimedia extravaganza that transmits a disorientating barrage of TV images and sound bites from all over the world.
European decadence. It's all right. And the Las Vegas crash. This is what we want.
You two have come down from the pulpit of high moral rock to offer a bombardment of truth, lies, and technology. Bono has hidden himself behind the sleazy rock greaseball, The Fly.
Girls, it's The Fly.
And a Las Vegas antichrist, McFisto.
I think there should be photographs of me with the children all over the world.
The truth, they claim, can be found beneath this mess of contradictions.
You know, last time we saw you, you were a normal guy.
You didn't like me when I was me, so I found somebody new.
Old blue eyes and fangs. Never kissed a cowboy.
There is so much uncertainty, there is so much confusion coming at you 24 hours a day on the electronic media and in the press, and we're just picking up on that.
Reaction to the media, it's more of a judo kind of thing. I mean, you use the energy of what's coming at you to defend yourself.
How long did you wait for tickets?
The whole advent of soundbite politics.
Music.
If you can't say it in a few seconds.
I came with $1,000 in cash.
And say it with sincerity.
And what was the answer?
And with the right hand gestures.
She didn't know it.
You're just not going to get through to people.
Hi, YouTube. YouTube?
Why do I like this band?
Well, how long do you have?
It's getting pretty nutty out there.
We used to broadcast what we believed in. Now we broadcast what we don't believe in. They're the two different sides of the same coin. It's just one's a lot easier than the other.
Hello, I'd like to leave a message for Alessandra Mussolini. I was a close friend of her grandfather's, and I just want to tell her she's doing a wonderful job filling the old man's shoes. We'll never let it happen again.
Well, I think sometimes you can actually get far closer to the truth, or the truth of what you're trying to say, in highlighting what it isn't, and in almost stating what it isn't, as if it was truth.
It's very simple.
That's assuming we know the truth. The truth's one of those words that has lost its meaning.
If you lose faith in words and in pictures, I suppose instinct takes over, which means music, I think, I hope. I mean, music becomes more important.
Sometimes I feel like I don't know. Sometimes I feel like checking out. I wanna get it wrong. Can always be strong. And love, it won't be long.
Sam Shepard said, right smack in the center of a contradiction, that's the place to be. Well, he's right.
We feel like we're slap bang in the middle of one major contradiction, which is the band itself.
What's important to me is what we do on stage. It's about music, it's nothing to do with media.
Well, yeah, I guess we're in the media business now.
I don't know. I mean, that's the one thing I know, is that I don't know.
Insincerity is a really important quality in rock and roll stuff. And I just didn't understand that for so long. I've really gotten the hang of it now, as you probably noticed.
Never trust a cowboy.
There are many, many levels to Zoo TV.
This is the lowest. This is...
John, It's coming towards the end of the show now, yes. And I should like to thank you for coming on and sharing your experiences with us about Amsterdam. I kind of almost feel I was with you in that toilet and on that tram with you, so thank you for that. Mm. And you'll be playing a song for us later, won't you?
Yes, sorry about my breath, by the way.
It's okay, I'm keeping my distance, you may have noticed. But first of all, we've got to go to the impeccably coiffured Johnny Vaughan to see how he did with his busk with the Bee Gees.
The events of something happening to me. There is something I would like you all to see. It's just a photograph of someone that I knew. Have you seen my wife, Mr. Jones? Do you know what it's like on the outside? Don't go talking too loud, you caught the landslide. Mr. Jones.
That's typical, isn't it? Listen, I hate to bust up the party. I've got to bust up the party. It's time to tally up the totals. What do you got down there, do you think?
I would say we've got about close to 100 quid, 57 quid, 80 quid.
Close on 100 quid. Wally?
7 quid.
£7, which means that the Bee Gees are this week's winners. Congratulations, lads. That's all from me this week. It's been a tremendous day's busking. We'll be back again next week with another band and another busker. Until then, trust everybody, but cut the cards.
Well, it's coming to that time of the evening again. The credits are rushing towards us like a winged serpent, so it only remains for me to say that I hope you like the programme. We're talking about you like the programme. I hope you love the programme. I hope you want to marry us all and bear our children and settle down with us in a nice cottage in the woods. I should like to point out that I'm still not a goth, and I should now like to leave you with John Hegley and Nigel Pinter giving a funky rendition of their new single. Take it away, lads.
This is Nigel. And I'm not sure if there's a single planned, but we do have an album out on Monday. It's called Saint and Blurry, and we're going to do a song that isn't on it, Nigel. Mm-hmm.
waiting. We're waiting for the credits. We're waiting for the credits to appear. Oh, here come the credits. Here come the credits. Oh, now the credits are here. A bit working class, but they weren't in the credits. They weren't in the credits. Oh no, they weren't in the credits. There was a young creature from space. He entered a three-legged race. But he wasn't very fast, in fact he came last, because he was a bag of oven-ready chips, but he wasn't in the credits.